Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Father Andres. Today we restart Ordinary Time after celebrating yesterday's Grace Feast, Pentecost. And it is not a coincidence that we start this week with a beautiful feast, the Feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church. So let us open our ears and our hearts and listen to today's Word of the Lord, which can be found in the Gospel according to John, chapter 19, verses 25 to 34.
Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine, so they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he handed over the spirit. Now, since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of that week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and then of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today, we remember Mary, Mother of the Church. In this sense, we contemplate the spiritual motherhood of Mary in connection with the Church, which is, in itself, Mother of the people of God. Since no one can have God for Father who has not the Church for his mother, says Saint Cyprian. Mary is the mother of the Son of God, and at the same time, mother of those who love her Son and those well loved by her Son. In accordance with that, "Woman, behold your son; disciple, behold your mother," which Jesus pronounced from the cross, giving his body to men and returning his spirit to his Father, Jesus Christ even gave his mother to his friends. And the greatest love is the one in which Jesus loves the Church, to which his friends belong. Therefore, children adopted by God cannot have Jesus as brother if they do not have Mary as mother, because while Mary loves her son, she loves the Church of which she is an eminent member. Which does not mean that Mary is superior to the Church, but that she is mother of the members of Christ, says St. Augustine. The Second Vatican Council adds that Mary is truly the mother of the members of Christ for having cooperated with her love for the faithful, who are members of that head, Jesus, to be born into the Church. Furthermore, while remaining in the midst of the apostles in the upper room, Mary, Mother of the Church, recalls the presence, gift, and action of the Holy Spirit in the missionary church. By imploring the Holy Spirit in the heart of the Church, Mary prays with the Church and prays for the Church, because already assumed in the glory of heaven, she accompanies and protects the Church with her maternal love. So today, let us beg and thank for this gift of having Mary as our mother. For Mary takes care of her children. We can therefore entrust to her the whole life of the Church, as did Pope Saint Paul VI. "O Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church," he said, "to you we recommend the entire Church and our ecumenical council." Here in these words, let us entrust not only the Church, this universal church, or our own personal churches in our own homes, communities, families, and friends, so that we may live under this maternal protection, receiving from her all the graces God is willing to give us. Never be afraid to give everything to Christ, for he takes away nothing but gives us everything. Have a blessed Monday. God bless.